politician, Mr. Patrick Callaghan, would call around to see the voters every now and then. He spent his time and money, sure he treated them so well. He'd leave them feeling tipsy, and well, then you'd hear them yell, call again, Mr. Callaghan. Tell us when you will call again. When you're around, here's one place that you can hang your hat. There's welcome on the mat, waiting for your pat. Might as well tell you now that we're proud of you. You're a fighter through and through. Sure, we like your style, your typical Irish mind. Call again, Callaghan.
Well, sure, a great man was Callaghan. During the Spanish War, sure, he was in the thickest of the fight at San Juan Hill. And when he returned home, I met him on the street. Well, hello, Sivine, how are you? Fine, Sivine. And I said to him, how did you feel during the battle when you were under fire?
Well, Sivine, I felt as though every hair in my head was a brass band and they were all playing Home Sweet Home.
Yeah. Oh, but in his younger days, Callaghan was a fine big man. He was that, then. I never forget one time he was working for a contractor. And one morning, the new boss called all the men together. And he says, I want to tell you men now that I can lick any man in the gang.
But to me, brave Callaghan stepped forward and he says, you can't lick me. That's enough from you, says the new boss. Go to the office and get your pay. You're fired. I won't have a man in this gang that I can't lick.
When the USA had gone to war and needed volunteers, and Callaghan responded, you should hear those Irish cheers. He formed a regiment of them, they proudly marched away. He won 100 battles, and we're shouting loud today. Callaghan, Mr. Callaghan. Tell us when you will call again. When you're around, here's one place that you can hang your hat. There's welcome on the mat, waiting for your pat. Might as well tell you now that we're proud of you.